We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Today is the celebrating the life of Mr. Lewis Ragland. We welcome you here. I think the song is going to have to be in the overflow. And we just thank God for the preparations that have been made by the Alexis Park and Pete Housley and the MIDI-VIP and the set. So we're going to follow the program as printed. If there's any changes, I will announce them to you. Thank you. Our Old Testament reading will be from Psalms 23, the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down on green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You have anointed my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord.
A distortion purple or loose cable purple?
Amen. Our New Testament, John chapter 14 and 6, beginning at verse 1. Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. For I go to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also.
And you know the way where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How do we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing and the doing of his holy word. Let us pray. Father in heaven, in the name of Christ, we come to say hallelujah, to bless you, to praise you. We come, Lord, to lay our sins before you, asking for the washing and cleansing in the name and blood of Christ. We thank you for this day of celebration, and we thank you for the victory that is available through faith in Christ, eternal life. Now, Lord, we pray a special blessing on Stella, the children, grandchildren, all the family, all the close friends, and all that are here, that you bless this time of celebration and that you comfort tears and comfort hearts as only you can. We're trusting in you to do it. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people said, amen, amen. We're going to follow the program as it is written. You will see, because of the social distancing rules, we have a video screen here, and the people that were going to perform live, trying to stay with the COVID restrictions and keep everybody safe, they have been recorded in a studio. So turn it over to the technicians.
Was born by the river. river I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, and I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living. I'm afraid to die. I don't know what's up there. Beyond the sky. Some folks keep telling me, Freddie, stop hanging around. Oh, a long time coming, and I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.
Westbrook. I am one of Lou's entertainment agents of many over the past 26 years. I met Lou in 94. He came to my office at Bourbon Street, a great gentleman, and introduced himself to me. And I was just producing a big show called Back to the 1940s for the Ramada Express in Laughlin. And of course, the world famous Ink Spots turned everybody's head. And with all those incredible vocals and talent, they're a hard act to follow. Louis Edward Ragland was born on July 18, 1942, to Carrie and Violet Ragland in Cleveland, Ohio. He had an older brother, Bobby, and a younger sister, Vivian. He inherited his love of music from his parents, and growing up, he learned to play alto sax, clarinet, and the tuba. In later years, he also learned to play the guitar and the organ. At the age of 13, Lou heard Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers. From then on, he was hooked and became passionate about music. While in high school, he formed his first vocal group. In his lifetime, he was a soul singer, instrumentalist, songwriter, producer, and label head. He traveled all over the United States, Great Britain, Japan, Australia, and New Zealand. His first recording was in 1963, Never Let Me Go. In the late 1970s, Lou left Cleveland for the West Coast and finally settled in Las Vegas, where he made his home for the last 40 years of his life. He remained busy as a performer and recording artist. Lou was preceded in death by his mother, Violet Ragland, his father, Carrie Ragland, and his daughter, Michelle Ragland. Lou is survived by his wife of 27 years, Estella Ragland, daughters Cosetta Ragland, Marcietta Coleman, and Nieda Miller. I hope I pronounced those right. Also his sons, Johnny Robertson, Louise Barkley, Eho Wilson, my apologies, Ejo Wilson, Daniel Ragland, Darnell Ragland, and a host of grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and nieces, nephews, and many, many friends, as you can see. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Henry. Go by Hank. This is Ryan, my son, Brandon. We're Rena's family from Stella. Just a quick something about Lou real fast. I met Lou in the year 2000, so I've known him for about 20 years. He was a great man, his own character. Everybody knows that. You know, he was his own self, and I appreciate all his help. He helped me raise these two boys right here. That was his favorite, but that's okay. But I do remember him taking him to the park. Pop got his arm broken from the monkey bars. But his arm's really good. He's a nice, big, strong guy. I really appreciate that man. And he was a great Pop to me. So, the family of Pop Lou Ragland would like to thank all of you here today for all who are here via the live stream. We would like to acknowledge the many expressions of sympathy and gestures and kindness shown to us following this sad news. We offer our heartfelt thanks to the many friends, neighbors, and well wishes who are visiting and providing emotional and practical support for us at this time who are traveled from out of state, long distances, all those who sent flowers, cards, and messages of condolences. We are truly grateful. A special thanks to Alexis Park Resort and its staff for their kindness to those who have helped us in any way, and their contribution has made our loss more bearable. And we appreciate all of you that showed up today. Thank you so much.
Only you can make all this world seem right. Can make the darkness bright. Only you and you alone can thrill me like you do and fill my heart with love for only when you hold my hand, I understand the magic that you do. You're my dream come true, my one and only. When you hold my hand, I understand the magic that you do. You're my dream come true, my one and only you.
My name is Lambus Dean, and this is one of the favorite songs that Lou thought I did so well, and we even produced another version of it, and I'd like to dedicate to this memorial for him right now.
Whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong, whether I find a place in this world or never belong, I gotta be me. I gotta be me. What else can I be but what I am? I want to live, not merely survive, and I won't give up this dream of life that keeps me alive. I gotta be me. I gotta be me. The dream that I see makes me what I am. That far away cry of world of success is waiting for me if I can. Hopeless, as long as there's a chance that I can have it all, I'll go it alone. That's how it must be. I can't be right for somebody else if I'm not right for me. I gotta be me. I just gotta be me. Daring to try to we'll be right back.
appreciate everyone being here to in this life celebration of my dad, who journeyed on to the next destination. Dad, I know that you are at peace because you are a spiritual warrior, vibrating on a different level now, watching over each and every one of us. You left behind a musical legacy for us and for the world to witness, your musical genius. Your songs and our love for you will forever be burned in our hearts and in our memories for a lifetime. You were a wealth of knowledge and wisdom. Your songs understand each other and the next world reflected your concerns for humanity, how we could do better in our lives as human beings. You also gave us love songs as well, telling us how we should treat each other with love, respect, and honesty. Dad, I'm gonna miss talking with you in the physical world, but I know your love and spirit will live on, manifesting itself in each of our lives, letting each of us know that you are still around, just vibrating on a different level. I thank you for giving me spiritual knowledge at such an early age, and the song of music in my heart, enlightening my mind and soul to become the spiritual warrior that I am today. Dad, I will continue to sing the songs of melodies that I receive from you. I know your soul soars high, and there are no human boundaries to stop you. You made it to the crossroad, a journey that each of us must take one day. This is not a goodbye, it's a see you later. Much love to you and for you, Dad. Love your daughter, Cazetta.
Having started, I guess, my career as a U.S. Army field artillery officer, I have to admit to this day, I still have a hard time being an early riser. So one of the benefits of being a personal manager for entertainers, particularly musicians, is they don't get up early in the morning. No early morning phone calls. And then I met Lou Ragland. This morning, as I was sound asleep, my home office phone rang at 6:15. And I had this chilled feeling for a moment that I was getting a call from beyond. But then I said, can't possibly be Lou because he never called before 6:30. By the way, I checked the voicemail. It was static. I Googled the phone number. Google tells me there's no such number. Once again, Lou was messing with me. But in my last phone conversation with Lou Ragland, Lou reminded me of a conversation that we had had several years earlier. Lou had called me to let me know that Fareed Braxton, who had been a longtime valued member of the famous world-famous Ink Spots, had unexpectedly passed away. And after a few minutes of talking with Lou and he and I finally recalling what a great guy Fareed had been, I reverted to being a personal manager and blurted out to Lou, "Lou, what are we going to do with Ink Spots without Fareed?" As Lou often did, there was a pause, a very long pause. And Lou said, and in my best Lou imitation, "Clinton, do you think this is the first time that an Ink Spot has passed away?" Well, when I last spoke with Lou a few weeks back, Lou recalled that conversation with me to make a very important point. He reminded me that the original Ink Spots quartet actually went through, I think it was 16 members over its two-decade history. And of course, since then, dozens of artists have carried on with the iconic sound of the Ink Spots. Lou let me know, in no uncertain terms, as he did so well, that he was getting ready to take his final bow. Then he said that it would be up to me, Eddie Coco Stancil, Fleury Berset, and many other artists to come to preserve the memories, the music, and the tradition of these American music legends. And with that said, Chris, I know you're standing by. Here's a video that we will roll out this coming week that I think expresses Lou's final wishes.
In music news, Lou Ragland, founder and frontman of the world-famous Ink Spots, the third generation of the legendary vocal quartet, passed away in Las Vegas at 78. For several decades, Ragland carried on the Ink Spots sound originally created by the legendary 1930s vocal quartet. In 1978, Ragland joined the George Holmes Ink Spots, and in 1993, Ragland promised Holmes prior to his death that he would carry on the tradition with the world-famous Ink Spots. Prior to his death, Ragland and the world-famous Ink Spots were performing at Alexis Park Resort in a residency, cut short by the COVID-19 pandemic closures. Las Vegas producer Pete Housley said, "It was a highlight of my career to work with this entertainment legend." It may not have been Lou's intention, but Lou Ragland certainly set the world on fire. Renowned as a Cleveland soul legend, Ragland recorded and produced numerous singles and albums, and in 2013, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame honored Ragland at an evening with Lou Ragland. The world-famous Ink Spots personal manager, Clinton Billups, said, "Although Lou Ragland has passed on, his longtime fellow Ink Spot Eddie Coco Stansel will carry on as leader and continue Lou's mission to preserve the memories, music, and tradition of these American music legends."
Would all this be true if I could catch her?
Make me a man, make me a man. I gotta be like Jesus was. Make me a man, make me a man. Like Jesus was. Oh, I gotta be like Jesus. When I lift up my voice to you, filled with the praise and glory of your love. Oh God, I wanna be just what you want me to be. And that's why I'm lifting up my voice to thee. Jesus, I'm calling on Jesus. Without Jesus, I'd never be the same. Jesus, I'm calling on Jesus. The name above all names. The name above all names.
Oh,
we're going to continue on. And before I get into the word, I want to read to you a couple of emails that came my way. Condolence from Manny Kellogg. I would like to send my deepest condolence to the entire Ragland family. It was indeed a pleasure to have known and worked with Lou and his world-famous Ink Spots. I will truly miss Lou. And like in one of their songs, we will meet again. The Lord gave and the Lord have taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Job 1:21. Rest in peace, my brother. May the memories of Lou be in our hearts forever. Manny Kellogg, legendary drummer and Grammy Award winner. That's from Mr. Manny Kellogg, all the way across the country. And then the members of Spectrum and Cushney Roberts could not be here. They had to travel yesterday. And this is a tip for many of the entertainment groups and the agents and managers. They're doing an outdoor concert in Oklahoma, outside concert with the symphony orchestra. So, hey, maybe there's a little revenue there we can pick up on, outdoor concert, socially distanced. From Cushney Roberts of Spectrum, it is with a heavy heart that I share my thoughts and memories of Lou Ragland, a very special man we lost on Wednesday, August 19, 2020. The passing of Lou leaves many voids and many pairs of large shoes to fill because he was a man of many facets. He was a devoted husband, father, grandfather, brother, musician, songwriter, composer, music publisher, record producer, video producer, et cetera, leader and lead singer of the Lou Raglands, world famous Ink Spots, soloist, a real and play uncle, community leader, teacher, mentor, and most of all for myself and many others, a dear friend. Despite all of these titles, Lou was a mystery man. He didn't go around touting his many achievements, but ask him about them and you would get an earful of stories, some interesting, some funny, some triumphs, some failures, some happy, some sad, but all good and most with a lesson to be shared. Some of his accomplishments, he was the role manager for the OJs when they started out, managed other groups in the Cleveland area. We heard many of these things. And he was the last surviving member who sang with any of the original members of the Ink Spots. We've heard about that. Then he goes on to say, for years at the Westside Las Vegas Arts Center, Lou mentored innumerable children and adults alike. I'd watch as he would familiarize them with sound equipment, recording and video equipment and computers. He would then hire them out to work on projects, adding pay, practical experience to their resumes as they mastered the skills to which he had introduced them. He was a constant proponent of bringing business and prosperity to the historic west side of Las Vegas, engaging city officials and challenging them not to overlook his community again and again. And he talks about how he met Lou, and finally he closes out to say, I was fortunate to get to spend some time with Lou during his final months, weeks and days, as he was remarkably lucid to the point of sharing ideas, giving solid business advice, and even making business deals when he wasn't up to communicating verbally. He'd point to a pad and paper and scribble a few words or test your skills in the game of charades to get you to figure out what he was trying to say, but he would get it done. On one of my last visits to his bedside, he had a James Brown's t-shirt on. Lou pointed to the shirt and smiled. I told him that he was our godfather, and Lou's life was a life well lived. He was well loved and will be sorely missed by me and countless others. That's from Cushney Roberts from Spectrum. Then before I preach, I just want a few notes down through the years on my friendship with Lou Ragland. I came to St. Louis from St. Louis with, where is he with the shiny jacket on? My long-term dear friend, Lionel Z from the Coasters, his wife Beverly. And Lionel and I sang in a group called Paper Bag. We came here trying to seek our fame and fortune, the bright lights of the Las Vegas Strip. We were doing a show at the former Newtown Tavern. Now, don't laugh when you hear the name Tavern, because they had a showroom that seated 500 people. And we played there, and then on this particular night, Lou's friend Pete Peterson, some of you may know Pete, had booked a band on the same show with us. I remember firsthand when I experienced Lou's expertise in arranging music production when he's rehearsing the Great Lakes Orchestra once at Love's Nightclub. How many people remember Love's on Jackson Street? Few of us remember that, okay? He was rehearsing this big orchestra, and I just watched him. It was Lou and Anthony Gibson. Oh, let me back. I'm getting ahead of myself. I would often venture downtown to the Four Queens and listen to the George Holmes Ink Spots. And some of you remember we could go over to the Horseshoe after 10 p.m. and get a $2 steak. I was one of those that was there every week. All right, every now and then I would run into George Holmes at Monday Night Jazz, and George would talk about me becoming the bass singer for the Ink Spots. And it never happened, but lo and behold, in 1990, I got the call. It was Lou and Anthony Gibson that taught me the harmony parts for the Ink Spots music. I was given a solo part on Old Man River, and it was Lou that taught me many of the microphone techniques that really helped my performance. Through the years, we recorded many songs. Some of you who've been part of these recordings, or Stella or the kids, will laugh about this. Some in Harvey Fuqua's studio, which was State of the Art, other State of the Art studios, but sometimes it was in the living room of the Ragland house. And at other times, it was in hotel rooms on the road. Lou would call me and say, Coco, come up here and put a part on this recording. And it was quite an experience. He was schooled in all types of music, gospel, R&B, arranging vocals, even mapping out video recordings. We cut a video years ago on VHS at Channel 33. And it was Lou who was telling the cameraman, you get on the floor and shoot up this way. You get on a ladder and shoot over this way. Lou had it down. He had it down. And then he knew about the staging. I was there when he recorded a video of Spectrum at the Smith Center. And he staged the choreography, staged the cameras, who came in, who came out, when the saxophone player came up, when who did what. Lou was good at that. As a songwriter and singer, he was tops, gospel or R&B, even Christmas music, because we did. Fleury was there, we recorded. What's the name? I don't know the name of it, but it's a Christmas CD. Okay, got a lot of Christmas songs on it. All right, no matter, but if you kept your ears open, you would learn something. Then finally, as my friend, I will never forget how he and the group came to my aid in times of needing assistance. I could be, my car, something happened, and when I looked up one time, I made one call, and everybody in the group was there to help me. Then another time, my wife was going to get her hair done somewhere on the west side, and she called me, said, I got a problem. I said, where are you? I think I'm down the street from Stella and Lou's house. So I called Lou. He said, man, that was your wife's car. Hit that thing. Okay. He went. I told him where the spare was in the trunk. He put the spare on. My wife got on her way. He was Johnny on the spot. The last thing about Lou, but the most important thing, and I don't remember, Stella, how many years ago it was, but we got a call from Stella. Lou had a severe asthma attack to the point the doctors didn't think he was going to make it. And we are in Valley Hospital, my wife and I go in the emergency room to talk with Lou. And I had to ask him this question as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Have you accepted Christ as your Savior and Lord? His answer was a resounding yes. I thank God for that answer, but that the Lord granted him many more years after that. He was my friend, and although I will miss him, through faith in Christ, I will see him again. And then just something I found at the Cancer Center, and just so you'll know, everybody in there doesn't have cancer. Some people go there for different types of infusions, B12, iron infusions. I take my wife there for iron infusions. But this was a point. What cancer cannot do, it cannot cripple love. It cannot shatter hope. It cannot corrode faith. It cannot destroy peace. It cannot kill friendship. It cannot suppress memories. It cannot silence courage. It cannot invade the soul, it cannot steal eternal life, and it cannot conquer the spirit. I found that very enlightening. And now, through praying about what to preach on, the Lord gave me a title. He's that kind of friend. John 15:12-17. And I will read the text real quickly. John 15:12-17. I'll start at verse 5 though. I am the vine, this is Christ speaking. You are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him, he bears much fruit, for apart from me, you can do nothing. Verse 12, this is my commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that one lay down his life for his friends. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this time where now it's time to break the bread of life. Thank you for all that have participated. We thank you for everybody in this room and the other room. We thank you for the technicians. We thank you most for your grace and mercy. We pray your blessings upon the family and all the dear friends of Lou. And now, use me to your glory as I break the bread of life, and that someone might ask the question, what must I do to be saved? In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Here we find in this 15th chapter of John, it made me reflect back with the title, He's That Kind of Friend. From an early age, I've been singing in church at home, and I'm gonna tell you this, at a time of deep despair, Lionel and I, 10 of us, came from St. Louis, and our hope was to, boy, we're gonna make it big on the strip. And I ended up working at UMC. I'm mopping the floor one night, hadn't sung on stage and God knows when, feeling in despair, lonely. Got home that night and the Holy Spirit said, what a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. So Lord said, preach, he's that kind of friend. Now, God had me reflect on the many years I've been a friend to lose, the countless performances, also how we watched each other's children grow up, each other's grandchildren. I remember my son over there, Corey, in the back. He was 10 years old. He'd be in the dressing room between shows at the Four Queens, and he'd be eating a sandwich, doing his homework. And I remember all Lou talked about was Junior, Stella, Cozella, all the children, Ryan. I mean, I remember all that stuff, watched them. And then there's a picture somewhere on one of these tables in one of these rooms from the show, the last show we did together here at Alexis Park. And he called all you guys on stage. You remember that, Junior? That's one of those pictures. So that makes me reflect. And I had to speak about this, about Christ Jesus, the only begotten Son of God. In the Gospel of John, we read verse 5, the importance of true friendship, fellowship with Christ is brought out in that scripture. I am the vine, ye the branches. He who abides in me and I in him, he will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. As branches, believers are to abide in him for the blessings and fellowship, but also for bearing Christian fruit. What is Christian fruit? That means the Bible says you weren't just saved to save yourself. You're saved to do good works unto the glory of God. So as believers, our first command is to abide in Christ. In verse 12, he gives us further instructions. This is my commandment, that you love one another just as I loved you. Keep in mind, Christ said, he didn't say it's a suggestion. He said it's a commandment, okay, that we love one another. And then in verse 13, he lays out the entire purpose of why the Father sent the Son into this world. Greater love has no one than this, than one lay down his life for his friends. The verse points us to John 10 and 11, which says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. These verses speak of the fact that Christ died and rose again for the sins of the world, that those who believe in him might have eternal life. Note, he now, as he moves into 14, he calls all believers friends. He says in 14, you are my friends if you do what I command you. 15, he no longer, listen to it, no longer do I call you slaves or servants, depending on the translation you might be reading from. For the servant or slave does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends. For all things that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. He calls us friends. He has made known the Father's things to us. Then in 16, you did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you would go and bear fruit, that your fruit would remain, so that whatever you ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. Christ chose every believer, and he has appointed us to bear fruit to his glory. Not so somebody can say, oh, did you hear Eddie Coco preach? Not so somebody can say, did you hear so-and-so sing or play? But that what we do brings glory to God. If we are faithful to him, we may ask the Father in his Son's name, Jesus, and according to his perfect will, he will grant our request. This is not naming and claiming. This is saying, if you ask the Father in the name of Christ, if it's in the Father's will, he will grant your wish. Everybody doesn't need a Rolls Royce. A Chevy will get you to work and back just as good. Okay? Nothing wrong with a Rolls Royce if you can afford it. But why live outside and sleep in the Rolls Royce? So keep things in perspective. The proof of God's love for us is shown by this. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. The final question today is, are you the friend of God? Have you accepted him as your Lord and Savior by grace through faith in Jesus Christ? Acts 4 and 12 tells us, there is salvation in no other name under heaven that has been given among men by which we must be saved. That name is Jesus. Have you given him your heart? Have you confessed your sins to him alone? And are you trusting in Christ alone for his redeeming blood? This is a time initially of sorrow. It wasn't fun to see my friend there laying, and the nurse came, and then the priest came, and we knew it was over even before they got there. Okay? It wasn't fun for the family and close friends, that the wife and children, grandchildren, Lambus and others that sat with him, Freddie, that held his hand. It wasn't fun. But I'm going to tell you this. Jesus is the kind of friend that he will hold your hand. He will dry your tears. He will bring comfort, because in Proverbs it says, in Proverbs 18 and 24, I believe it says, he is a friend that sticks closer than any brother. And if we have, I'd like everybody to close their eyes real quick. If this ceiling collapsed and the building caved in on us, and you know for sure that you would go to heaven and be with Christ, thank God for that. But if you're not sure, and if you have never accepted Christ as your Savior, nobody look around. I'm not looking. You just, in your heart, ask him now to come into your heart. Ask him to forgive your sins and make you his child. He will give you eternal life based upon your faith in him as Lord and Savior. Amen. Father in heaven, we commit Lou's body right now in the name of Christ, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for that day when the return of Christ will come, and all the world shall see him, to the glory of God. Amen.
Come on, Father. I just want to preface this quick, simple benediction of the ashes with a comment of hardly knowing Lou, but delightful to be part of his life. Father Gene, come up. Because Lou shared with us a big part of his life, which is the Stella. And Lou, in this crisis, helped us convey the Holy Mass to many who couldn't come to church, because he helped with his technological skill and his equipment. And one time, I don't know what happened to me. I just started preaching up a storm. I started talking like this. And, you know, Catholic priests don't do that sort of thing. But Lou looked up at me and said, now you're preaching. after, you know, filming us for just the most boring, must have just been so boring. Jonathan, don't you even go there. So, Father Gene, we need to bless these ashes. A simple prayer over his remains. Lord Jesus, we ask that you bless these remains of Lou, that your spirit be with them, that Lou's spirit be with them, and that you might bring Lou to heaven and to eternal life in the forgiveness of all his sins through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
In the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
So we're going to have a quick prayer of benediction. Bow your heads, please. Father in heaven, we thank you for the celebration of life. Thank you for all who have come, all who have participated, most importantly, for the blood of Jesus that not only cleanses sin, but that he is the friend that sticks closer than a brother. Bless Stella and the family and the friends as we go forth from this place. Hold us in the palm of your hand that we might be strengthened by your grace every day. And we pray this in Jesus' name. And all God's people said, amen. Thank you.
Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, yes, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the sun refuses to shine, oh, when the sun refuses to shine, oh, yes, I want to be in that number when the sun refuses to shine. Oh, when they crown him Lord of Lords, oh, when they crown him Lord of Lords, oh, yes, I want in that number when they crown him Lord of Lords. Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be in that number when the saints go marching in. Yes, Lord, I want in that number when the saints